Here is a dairy farm, but is a special kind of dairy farm. This is a dairy farm where we are imparting knowledge specifically to the smallholder dairy farmers. In fact, we are a school of smallholder dairy farmers. A lot of dairy farmers are gaining knowledge that is transforming their lives in northern Uganda through this smallholder farmer school in northern Uganda. Killing of dairy farmers and the skilling of young people in northern Uganda has given us immense money, more than actually the milk that we are in. And that's why I keep saying that we are a school of smallholder dairy farmers. That is what is paying our bill. But also that is what is transforming the lives of farmers. Knowledge is wealth. Definitely, I'm a veterinarian by profession. Right now, as we talk, we now talk about ice cream mix. We now actually have business-to-business relationship with our customers out there to supply them ice cream mix. And here, in this process of ice cream mix, both of us are winners. Not like those days where I used to be the only champion. You have outlets everywhere. But this time, we are a business-to-business relationship, and we are both winning in this game. I've now transformed to even digital records. Right now, as I talk, a lot of activities happening on the farm is happening on my phone. The phone alerts me these days about the expected date of my cows. The phone alerts me how much milk every day has come in. The phone alerts me on when I should inseminate a cow. So we have transformed from just paper record keeping to digital record keeping, and we are still moving on. I was making yogurt before. But I can assure you right now, we are even making ice cream, which is bringing more profit than what I used to do in yogurt. Right now, as I told you, we now do what we call the ice cream mix. We only supply the ice cream mix, quality ice cream mix, to the small retailers in town, and we are expanding and expanding all over northern Uganda. Ice cream making machine for production, it produces 20 liters of ice cream every 20 minutes. We also have a yogurt production machine, which makes about 1,000 liters of yogurt every 8 hours. We have a hay baler there. It can bale thousands of bales in an acre. So we are having a machine that is making our life easy. The tractor is here making our life easy. We have the planter making our life easy. We have the cultivator making our lives easy. We have a hay rake, which helps us to throw hay on the line for it to be used by the hay baler. So really, machine has made our life easy. Every day we have a protocol. You know, 5 a.m. we milk our cows, we clean up, we weigh our milk, send the milk to the market, but also fresh. Part of it now we make into ice cream and supply all our shops. And then in the afternoon we milk again and supply that milk. And then in the evening, 3 times a day, we milk and supply our milk. We close the day by ensuring that the cows have eaten enough and have enough feed on their table. And we make sure the hygiene, the watering place for the cows is all clean, so that we start the next day with the same routine. It is the same day in and out. It is just a routine. We have silage that can last for 6 months now. I have hay. This hay will feed my cows until May. I still have more hay that I'm going to cut. So life is good. None of our staff were taken out during the COVID-19. We all stayed working and we all stayed in production. We buy hay from farmers, local. So the local community is supplying hay here. We decided that cowpeas must be supplied by the local communities. In the last 1 year, we were able to buy cowpeas worth 15 to 20 million. Or whereas my wife has been part of this. She has been an advisor. She has been a financial advisor. She was even working on setting systems of record, especially in the finance. She's very strong in the finance, but also she's very strong with the counseling. She helps to counsel our workers. She helps to encourage and motivate our workers. And she is the pillar of this farm.